Today we are going to explore EU-889 bidirectional power amplifier. This amplifier can be used for both 868 and 915 MHz. One of my respected viewers, Taken Global, asked me to show how everything is connected. So in this video, I will give a bit more time on interconnection as well. This circuit starts with a Heltec V3 Meshtastic device. Heltec V3 comes with a built-in antenna. To feed the output of Heltec V3 into another system, filter or amplifier, we need to replace this antenna with an SMA connector. So this is what I am going to do now. If you have tool to remove IPEX, that is great. If not, no worries. You can remove it like shown in the video. Installing the IPEX connector is not that difficult. Just put it there and push it with something. A click sound will make sure that it has been installed properly. We send transmissions through this node using Android Meshtastic app. Here you can see the settings of the app, and this is the message screen. All the transmissions are sent through this screen by sending meaningless messages. For this experiment, we do not need any other node to receive this message. Signal from this node is being fed into a 868 MHz SAW filter. This filter is directly connected to EU-889 bidirectional RF amplifier. This amplifier has a maximum transmission power of 31 dBm, which is equivalent to 1.3 watts. This is a bidirectional amplifier, so it has two parts, one for the transmission or a TX amplifier and other for the reception. We can call it LNA or low noise amplifier. It has auto switching capability. This green LED here shows that it is in a receive mode, so its LNA circuit is working now. When it detects a transmission, this LED turns red, and at that time LNA circuit is pushed out of the circuit and TX amplifier is now switched into the circuit. This process is automatic. Today's video is focused on the TX side of the amplifier, so we will not discuss LNA features. Output of the amplifier then goes to attenuators. There are two attenuators. Here is our attenuator and power meter setup. This power meter can work from minus 55 dBm to minus 5 dBm. We are working here with the a bit higher power levels, 31 dBm or 1.3 watts. So if we put this power directly into the meter, it will burn out. Solution lies in the attenuation. We are using here 30 watt 30 dB attenuator and add another attenuator of 20 dB 2 watt to make it 50 dB. When we put two attenuators in series, their dBs will add. 30 plus 20 is 50 dB. However, their power handling capacity is the capacity of the smallest attenuator, which in this case is 2 watt attenuator. Now we connect these two attenuators with the power meter and power up power meter with a USB cable. It works on 5 volts. This meter can give a direct readout, but for that we have to put the attenuator value into the meter. In this case, we will add 50 dB attenuator value. Output of the attenuator is then fed into a power meter. From the power meter display, we can read how much power is being sent to antenna. Right now we do not have any antenna, and in place of antenna we are using power meter and attenuators. In the real life, this attenuator and power meter setup is replaced by an actual antenna. In the scenario 0, we are transmitting 22 dBm, which is going to the meter via attenuators. Meter reads 20.4 dBm. It is less than the expected value of 22. There could be many reasons for this. In scenario 1, we are sending 22 dBm from Heltec V3 to the amplifier. On the meter, we see a reading of 28.1 dBm. There is some insertion loss of saw filter. In scenario 2, we have changed the location of the band pass filter. We have placed it now after the amplifier. Let's find out the results. Power meter still reads 27.1 dBm. In scenario 3, we have just removed the band pass filter. Transmit power is still 22 dBm. And now we can see that meter reads as 30.8 dBm, which is very close to the specification of 31 dBm. It will give you the idea of what happens to the power if we use filter before the amplifier or after the amplifier in a TX scenario. It will be an entirely different story in case of the receive scenario. See you again in another video.